حواس پاک اج کرم کرو اج کرم کمان دا ویلا اے اج کرم کمان دا ویلا اے اج کرم کمان دا ویلا اے یا حواس پاک.
What's the first point of fard? First point of fard, something which is established from a definitive source of legislation, that is fard. Meaning if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you to do something in the Quran, it is fard. Second point of fard, if you do it, you are rewarded. If you don't do it, you are sinful and you will be held accountable in the hereafter. That is a sin, you will be punished. Point number three of fard, the denier of fard is designated a kafir, a disbeliever. And point number four for fard is that if you neglect a fard in an act of worship, that act of worship becomes invalid. It's invalid. Now the direct opposite of fard, the opposite of fard is haram. You can see that haram. That's the direct opposite of fard. Now, haram is something which is established from a prohibitive command. From a prohibitive command established in a definitive source of legislation. Again, the sources of legislation, one of the sources of legislation is the Quran. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you not to do something in the Quran, then that is haram. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا تقربوا الزنا, do not go near zina. That's a prohibitive command. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you not to go near zina, which means zina is haram. Fornication is haram. Adultery is haram. Now this is very important. We all need to understand haram. Because a lot of people, they say gyarvi is a bid'ah muharrama. Gyarvi is a reprehensible innovation which is muharram. According to them, it is haram to organize gatherings on the names of awliya, to establish gatherings on the name of awliya. They say it is haram. So it's all important for us to understand the definition of haram. What is haram? The prohibitiveness of which is established from the Quran, from any definitive source of legislation. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you not to do something and the command is a clear-cut command, its prohibitiveness has no ambiguity. It's a clear prohibitive command that makes a haram. Is that clear to all of you? This is a very important point. We all need to understand this. So what is haram? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you not to do something in the Quran, and it's a clear order, then that makes a haram. Now the next one, and also these two are connected. Fard and haram, they are connected. If something is fard, neglecting it is haram. If something is fard, neglecting a fard is haram. And if something is haram, neglecting a haram is fard. Do you understand? Neglecting a haram, refraining from a haram, not doing a haram is fard. And not doing a fard is haram. So salah is fard. If someone neglects their salah, then they've committed haram. And fornication is haram. Neglecting fornication is fard. It's fard not to commit zina. That's the link between the two.